Hello, my fellow Latter Day Saints. Kenzie Retchio here, back once again with Walking Dead Reactions, Season 9, Episode 2. I'm recording this on Thursday. It was supposed to go up yesterday, but I've had a lot going on this week, so I've just not had the time to be able to get the stuff up as scheduled. But nevertheless, here we go.
The following program contains scenes of strong violence and horror.
It's been a while since we had one of these talks. Don't say it. I know. I'm the one who does most of the talking. I'll try to keep it short. But you're up late anyway, and it's past time I get you up to speed. Today was day 35. And things are really taking shape. It wasn't that long ago. We were fighting just to stay alive.
Mm-hmm.
But it's not like that anymore. We're building. We're growing. We're still ready to deal with this world on its own terms. But we're not letting it define us anymore.
Mm-hmm.
We're getting back a piece of who we used to be. How things were before all this.
Mm-hmm. It's all the signpost that says the future, eh? Interesting.
We're not just fighting to survive anymore. We're making a new beginning.
And like I said in the previous episode, I just love this new title sequence.
You should be proud, Annie. The work you've done here.
Hey, King Ezekiel!
Someday
love
you'll
this guy.
This bridge with your grandchildren. Tell them the story of how it was built.
I'm not gonna bore my grandkids telling them a story about a bridge.
It's not just a bridge. Roads are the lifeblood of civilization. Rome rose and fell with its roads. Without this bridge, there'd be no trade. Bullets from Alexandria, grain from Hilltop, fish from Oceanside. This boring structure connects us all. Be proud. And be back in an hour to pack. We're going home.
Hey. Oh, going back to the kingdom. Woohoo! Hello.
Thanks.
Aww.
Did he get taller? I think he's taller.
He'll be off to college before we know it. If the kingdom didn't need me, and Henry didn't have school, I'd stay here to drive in the last nail myself.
Well, that'd be the only reason you'd stay.
There might be one other.
Mm-hmm. Sanctuary's not ready yet, so I'll be heading back there after.
Thought that might be the case.
But it still doesn't
matter. I know. Fairy tales end with heroes living happily forever, but in the real world, in this world, it's about finding the small moments.
Mm-hmm.
Getting to have as many of those moments as possible. This is just goodbye for now. I'm not giving up on the fairy tale. Hell no.
In regards to our makeshift levee upstream, given the current rate of spring runoff, I'd put its expiration date at another 6 to 9 days. After that, it's slam, blam, sayonara, coffer dam.
How fast can we have those supports ready?
Well, ditto on the 6 to 9, but if we boost our juice and shed the lid, I think we can beat it.
Good. I'll talk to the foreman and make sure we do.
Scouts got back. Hurry's just gonna pass us by, but it'll be close.
We got a head count?
100 and change. Now you think we should push the blasting?
No. If we wait, we'll wind up drawing that other herd.
Margaret.
Right. And that one's 5 times as big. We got the sirens in place.
Hell yeah.
Then we blow the rock slide. If the herd comes, we'll redirect.
All right, I'll let him know.
Anything on those walk-offs?
As of head count this mañana, we're down one more savior. That's 6 in the past month.
I'll talk to Carol about it.
Roger that and Wilco.
Mm-hmm.
Lucky it's not infected. Next time, come see us right away.
I know, I just felt stupid. Peeling a potato is a pretty dumb way to end up in the infirmary.
Yeah, well, it's an even dumber way to get gangrene.
How's the star student doing?
Ready to take on anything.
Good. She's gonna get her chance. I'd like you to head back home. There's a bug going around.
Okay. I'll head out with the next escort.
Wait, he's leaving? Ow! Sorry. It's fine. I've got this.
Yeah, I know.
My final line item is foodstuffs or lack thereof. Alexandria stretched way for Slim supplying grub to both the camp and the sanctuary. Me and I wait for Slim pickings are getting way for Slim by the day.
Yeah. Michonne's on it.
Whoa, whoa! Easy.
Oh, breaking the horse, yeah. I learned that term from Red Dead Redemption, folks.
Good boy.
There we go.
Hey.
Hey, Jesus and Michonne.
Hey,
woo!
Sanctuary, yeah.
You found out anything?
They're saying they sent the ethanol out last week like they promised.
Well, it's still not here.
Yeah, Jesus mentioned that. I don't know what happened.
They could be lying.
I don't think they are. Maybe the guys who made the delivery were taken down by walkers or they went AWOL, but we need the food. I was hoping you might send enough to tide them over while we figure this out.
We could do it. We have the surpluses.
You have it for how long? Till we get that fuel? That tractor's not moving. Which means the big fields don't get plowed and the yield comes in short.
What about the plow we brought back from the museum?
I need a blacksmith to fix it, and I don't have one right now.
How long is Earl going to be locked up?
I don't know. I haven't decided. First time we've had to deal with something like this.
It might be time, then. Start talking about making some rules. Do you think he'd ever do something like this again?
I didn't think that he'd do it the first time.
Well, you didn't hang him like you did Gregory. There must be a reason for that.
So should I let him walk like nothing happened?
Yeah, that was a big shocker, the fact that she hanged Gregory. And I was like, what the heck, Maggie?
But if keeping him locked up means that the crops don't get planted, then it's not just him that gets
finished. Hilltop will be fine. Until that ethanol shows up, we're holding on to our surpluses because we're going to need him.
If you say so.
It's a long ride back to Alexandria. You're welcome to stay the night here if you'd like.
Thanks. I will.
Come on, I'll get you set up.
Good to know.
So, I go in after her nap and pick her up, and the diaper just explodes all over me.
Oh, gross!
You'll see. What? You'd be a great dad.
Yeah.
Thanks, kid.
Easy there, buddy. I'm still thirsty.
No, there's not enough. You can't.
Give me a rest, kid.
Uh-oh.
Back off!
That's him, told.
Hey, man, it's cool. I got my ass handed to me by a kid one time, too. Of course, I was 6 at the time.
Uh-oh.
Hey, kid's just doing his job. Get back to work. I don't need you people telling me what to do. You're not my babysitter anymore.
And here comes... Oh, see, this is the dissension I was talking about in the first episode.
Paddy Power Games sponsors The Walking Dead on Fox.
And I've still got to sit through the blasted advertisements!
Hey, there's juicy beauty news. It's Herbal Essences Bio Renew, a fragrant blend of essences like citrus, exotic spices, and argan oil. Yes, 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 to an amazing antioxidant that helps to revive and protect, so my hair feels full of life, with no parabens, colorants, or gluten. Isn't that juicy? Find ahs and oohs in every amazing scent of Herbal Essences Bio Renew. Herbal Essences.
Tuesday nights get dangerously boring. A hero will rise. A fat hero.
Hey!
With a surprisingly beautiful wife.
Turn that off!
Isn't it funny, Peter?
No. Oh, wait.
What's wrong?
Hello?
I'm talking to him anymore.
New season of Family Guy? Woo! Well,
son of a...
All new episodes, Tuesdays at 10 p.m.
Finally! New episodes of Family Guy! Wait. Took them long enough!
Oh, this is gonna be fun.
The brand new season of Family Guy starts 30th October on Fox.
I mean, not funny.
Oh, shut up, Peter.
Paddy Power Games sponsors The Walking Dead on Fox.
And here we go.
I've been scheming and dreaming about padding out our pantry via repurposing expired canned goods and condiments. By boiling old ketchup and cooling it with new cubes, I bet we can produce us a passable gazpacho.
Well, Rick's cottoned on. Here we go.
Go back to work.
So that asshole just gets a free pass, is that it?
It's just a few more days. I don't like it either, but we're in a rush to get that work done. He's strong. The Saviors are over half the workforce, and we've had too many walk off already.
Yeah, because that's who they are. Some of them ain't ever gonna fall in line just because you say so.
Daryl's right. These people have never had to live together. We can't expect them to just forget what's happening.
No, it hasn't been easy, I know. It won't be. Not for a while, but... It's not about forgetting. It's about moving ahead, all of us, together.
Preach it, Rick. Preach it. Testify, my brother.
Are we, though? We on the same side, Rick. Well, you tell me. Thing is, man, I've been trying to. You don't seem to want to hear it.
Daryl.
It's complicated. It's been different since Gregory, maybe since before that.
You should talk to him.
You'd say what?
I get what you're trying to do here, and it's the right thing. But maybe for some of them, they're just not ready for it.
without Maggie.
He's my husband. You have to let me see him.
Of course you're going to see him, but we can't do this today.
So, if not today, when? I deserve a damn answer.
Tammy, please.
No, tell me when I get to see my damn husband.
Tammy, oh, boy.
My boy is dead. My husband is locked up. Nobody even talks to me anymore because they don't know what the hell to say. I don't have much, but I've still got rights. Are you going to take those away from me, too?
He tried to kill Maggie. He tried to kill her, Tammy. Just give her a little bit to figure it out.
All right. All right. You tell her that I am not moving until she lets me in there. You go. Go ahead and tell her that. I got no one else. I got no place else to be.
Okie dokie.
Are you going to talk to her about it?
Peggy? She'll do what she wants to do.
But what do you think?
I think it's not my call.
But do you agree with it?
I don't know if she hanged Gregory for everyone, for herself, or both. But I'm not against a grieving mother seeing her husband.
Then you should talk to her. She trusts you. She listens to you.
And I trust her. Her instincts, if not her every decision. No one's right all the time. Not her, not me, and not you.
That's why we need to build something that's bigger than any one of us.
Okay.
Higher? Lower.
Lower, maybe?
Like this?
Yes. That's her. You're very talented. Take it from the half-blind art critic.
I like doing it. Feels intimate. Like I'm one of you.
You are one of us.
Thanks to you. And Rick and Morgan, you're the ones that reached out to me. The others...
The others will come around.
Oh, yeah.
Nobody trusted me at first either.
I gave him good reason not to.
Same here. Believe me. But then Rick reached out to me, too. He's good like that.
He's not the only one.
Hello?
Well.
What would it catch someone's attention?
Being there.
Maybe we can vent that trailer or move the school outside till the heat wave's over.
I'll let Birdie know.
Oh, so cute!
Twins drop off another letter from Georgie?
No, I was just reading one of the old ones she sent. Thinking about how much she's done for us. How much she's still left to do.
You thinking about joining her? You know she'll never get tired of asking.
No, I like her ideas, but not that much.
I bet she's got a killer record collection by now.
I'm plenty busy building a future right here. Aren't we? Aren't we? What are you thinking?
Tammy Rose. She's been asking to see Earl for over a month now.
You think that's unfair?
I think some decisions are too big for one person to make. But that's why we used to have laws.
You've been talking to Michelle.
She's not wrong, mate.
Negan, Gregory, Earl. You won't say it, but you think I'm wrong about them.
I think you're a good person.
Well, I mean, the fact that Maggie wanted Negan dead, personally, if it were up to me, I would have done the same. I would have killed Negan. I would have killed the maniac. He killed Abraham and Glenn. And Maggie still hasn't forgiven him for that. And I don't blame her.
I've been trying to see you every day. I've been trying to see you.
Oh, it's okay. I'm okay. You treat me fair. It's more than I deserve.
Don't say that.
Well, it's true, though. It is. 20 years sober. I brought shame to you and Kenneth's memory. I didn't mean to.
Earl, you made a mistake. You lost yourself. But you came back. You're here now. And I forgive you. You hear me? God forgives you.
Tammy, it's not your forgiveness I need. I just miss him so much.
Me too. Me too.
Maybe we should be farther back.
It's fine, trust me.
Would you trust me?
Would you slice my face open with a knife? Not really.
Fire in the hall!
It's a lot of walkers. That's a lot of walkers! Unless...
Paddy Power Games sponsors The Walking Dead on Fox.
They're the Whisperers, possibly?
Join that geo world and enjoy a whole week dedicated to the amazing lives of Croctober.
Paddy Power Games sponsors The Walking Dead on Fox.
I never figured when I asked you to build these cells, you'd be the first person I'd have to stick in one.
Ooh, pleasant.
Tell me about the drinking.
Oh, boy.
What do you want to know?
I want to know how you got here.
I started drinking right after I quit smoking. How's that for ironic? It wasn't something that got out of control. It was always bad. I was drunk the day Kenneth was born. Hell, I can't even remember the first time I saw him. I joined AA after that. When Kenny was two, me and Tammy were barely making ends meet. I guess the stress of it all got to me, I don't know. I was on my way to pick him up from the sitters, and I saw the sign for McDuffie's off the highway. The sitter could smell the whiskey on me, she told me. She didn't want to hand him over. She tried to grab my keys. But I wouldn't give her a choice. I took my son and I put him in the truck. The next thing I remember, I was pulled off the road and Tammy was there.
Good grief.
I called her, I guess. Told her I was drunk. And she came to pick us up and take us home. I thought for sure she'd be gone after that, but she stuck around. She said I was sick.
that we swore to stay together no matter what, and that's what we were gonna do. I never took a drink after that. I wasn't even tempted. At least, not until... Well, you know the rest.
Thank you.
Did you hang Gregory and not me? I mean, I was drunk and I was weak, but what I did to you was in me. Gregory didn't make me do anything.
You think I made a mistake?
No.
Good.
Tara, you got something to report?
Yeah, Horatio just hit its mark.
Right on schedule.
Okay. Let's do this.
Copy that, Mother Goose. Piper One, crank it up.
Copy, Eye in the Sky. Piper One is a go.
Never living that one down.
Asked me to check up on the saviors who got AWOL. I just heard back from...
Yeah, I wanted to talk to you about that. Just hold on.
Tara, how's it look?
Yeah, we got them. They're turning.
Good. Keep an eye out for stragglers. Let them clear the camp, then fire up number two before they reach the lumber site.
Copy that. Paper two, on my go.
What about those saviors?
I just heard back from Sanctuary. None of the guys who walked off made it back home.
None of them?
No, and some of them had families. One guy had a new kid. There's no way they just up and left them.
So what do you think is going on?
Yeah, I don't know, but the Sanctuary group's getting worried, and they're the only ones here without guns,
yeah,
so...
Well, we disarmed Sanctuary for a reason.
Piper 2, this is Eye in the Sky. Come in, please.
There are more of them here than from anywhere else, and they're scared. If they wind up deciding they're safer back home, this whole thing's a wash.
Well, I'll make sure they're protected.
Oh, so they work for you, and you protect them, huh? Who's that sound like to you?
Piper 2, come in. Do you copy?
Tara, what's going on out there?
That second siren isn't going off. If the herd isn't pulled soon... They're gonna run right into our crew.
That's not good! That is definitely not good.
A herd's coming, bug out now!
Oh, Jesus, we gotta get the hell out of here.
Oh, crumbs! Daryl's like, screw this! I'm gonna take them all, or I die trying. Oh! Oh! Oh my! Oh no! Oh my! No, no, no! That's God for... Thanks. Now let's get out of here. Oh my, that is horrible to see! Good grief! That's a horrific sight! Good luck trying to mend that in a hurry! If you can, of course. But at this point, it doesn't look like.
That was
trouble. Ah, Zeke, he's back! Woohoo! What's he planning? Incoming! Oh! Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo! Well, what else are you supposed to do at this point?
You got something for the pain?
It wouldn't kick in fast enough. We have to do this now.
Oh, sorry, man.
I need you to hold him down for me.
Just hope she knows what she's doing.
And I don't give a shit what you were trying
to. Who's supposed to turn that hurt?
Oh boy.
The walkie wasn't charged. Bullshit. It's a solar walkie. You didn't think to check it?
Not my fault the radio's a piece of shit.
Oh boy, so it looks like this is going to be the storyline throughout the entire series. Just dissension within everyone in the- Oh! And now I understand why people don't want Daryl to be the new protagonist of the show. He's just so unhinged at this point, and I- What?
There's only one way to deal with this asshole.
Well, how else are you supposed to deal with them? Good grief!
Paddy Power Games sponsors The Walking Dead on Fox.
The future belongs to all of us now.
Bringing all these people together. You ever think about what they do? If they're good?
We're gonna have to fight whether we want it or not. Before it begins,
we're going for a side chase.
You do this, there's no going back. Everything we're doing, it ends.
The new season of The Walking Dead continues Monday at 9 on Fox.
Paddy Power Games sponsors The Walking Dead on Fox.
You've done something amazing with this place. And I didn't come to say otherwise.
I know what you came to do. And I've thought about it. We can talk about common laws. But I'm not giving up the right to do what I think's best for my people.
And neither will we. But I do think what is best for everyone will wind up being what's best for Hilltop, too.
Maybe.
I hope so. I asked Jesus to load up the food like we promised. All of it. Earl still owes us a debt, but he'll pay it. He'll work under supervision, and the council will help me decide when it's time for that to change. The plow will be fixed. The fields will get planted.
If you don't mind me asking, what changed?
You know my daddy drank? He was a good man. And if he hadn't have been given a second chance, a lot of people would have been worse off for it.
I count myself as one of them.
But Gregory, he had chance after chance and he wasted them all.
Maggie.
I don't regret what I did, Michelle.
Okay.
Some people can be redeemed. But others can't.
And who makes that decision?
I guess that's one of the things we have to figure out.
Hey, you need to keep your dog on his leash.
Excuse me?
You heard me. The bitch of yours damn near killed me over nothing.
I know you. See, I used to be a cop. And every Saturday night, I'd pick up some dipshit like you and have to listen to him run his mouth in the back of my car. Everyone trying to blame someone else for their own damn problems.
I don't need to listen to this.
Wrong. You're gonna stand there and listen to every word. Nah, I gave you the benefit of the doubt. That is done. Now, you pack your shit and get out of here first thing in the morning. If I see your face again, stitches won't fix what I do to you.
Uh-oh.
Wouldn't stay if you begged me. I'm not waiting till morning either.
Thanks.
Well, at least it wasn't a walker bite. So he should be okay, hopefully.
He's gonna be alright.
Emphasis on hopefully.
If we can keep the wound from getting infected. But he's still in a lot of pain.
He's holding on though.
Think?
Supposed to be working together. I thought we were, but I couldn't have known. I've been pushing everyone hard. I know I have. I put this project first, and you paid the price.
And the dead started to rise. I thought I was seeing the end of everything. But you changed all that, Rick. It's not the end of the world anymore. It's the start of a whole new one. I'll always be glad I was here to be.
Hear that? Those are frog mating calls. Must be one wild frog party going on out there.
That is a strange thing to know.
I grew up playing in the woods. Sounds like home to me.
Can I ask you a personal question?
If I said no, would it stop you?
Who's that woman you had me draw?
Come on. We don't talk about your past, but mine's fair game.
You can ask me about my past. Just don't ask me to tell you my secrets. That what she was? Secret? Forbidden love, perhaps?
No, it's nothing like that. She was my organist, my church. I cared for her very much. But I was afraid. And I lost her.
Thought priests were celibate.
I'm Episcopalian. I'm not Catholic. My vows don't prohibit me from...
Well, if that's not stopping you, then what is? You still afraid? If that is the case, I'm going to be very disappointed.
I'm supposed to be on watch.
On watch?
You still carrying that old ring around?
Oh, yeah.
Fine, man. No, I'm not saying yes. I just thought I'd try it on for a while. You know, while you're going.
Whatever you say.
No, don't.
Oh, come on.
Don't. I'm not kidding.
But I wrote a speech.
I'm sure you did. And you can read it to me later.
It was a hard day. Hardest we've had in a while. A man lost his arm. Projects behind schedule. People were at each other's throats. Thing is, though, bad as it was, when the day was done, they came together. Not all of them, but enough. They chose to be together. You see what I'm getting at? No matter what happens, it's human nature to come together. That's just what we do. That's a real pretty picture you paint there, Ray.
Negan!
When do I get to see you?
When's the last time we heard him?
You can die behind these bars. You know that. Well, then. Don't I get some kind of final request? Why don't you bring... Don't you ever get tired of acting like you're still in charge? Do you... You think just because they had a little weenie roast that you got all this on lock? When it finally goes to shit... And it will. Make sure you come back and you tell me all about that day, too. We're thriving without you. Building a future, just like I said we would. Building it for who? For Carl. You don't
don't speak his name.
Your family's gone, Rick. Same as mine. The bridge, it's not the future. It's a monument to the dead. You're not saving the world, Rick. You're just getting it ready for me.
And Negan's still the evil, maniacal psychopath that he is. Why am I not surprised? Why am I not surprised? Is that a chopper or a plane? Now, why would he be? Uh-oh. Why would he be out by himself? There's obviously something in there.
Christ, you damn near got yourself killed. What the hell are you...
What the hell?! And that's where they leave it! Come on! Oh my word! Now, who could possibly be the person that... That's what I'm looking for. Who could possibly be the person that took him out? Guess we'll have to find out in the next episode. In the meantime, hope you enjoyed what you saw. If you did, as always, hit the thumbs up. And if you want to be baptized into following this channel, hit the subscribe button down at the bottom. Click the bell to join the Latter-day Saints notification squad so you don't miss anything I do on this channel. F1 2018 on the left. And on the right, my Walking Dead playlist. I said, I've just realized I've flipped the camera. So, this is, that's the right, that's the left, yeah. So yeah, so I'm literally looking into a mirror here. Anyway, enjoy the rest of your day, peace out, and stay faithful as always.